Yeah, back on the SportsMax Zone, let's take to the track for a discussion. Yeah, those who braved the late afternoon rain to witness the sixth staging of the Racers Grand Prix were treated to a series of fantastic performances at the World Continental Tour Silver Meeting in Kingston on Saturday. Let's start on the track, where Jamaica's Oblique Seville produced a blistering world lead and personal best 9.82 seconds to win the men's 100 meters ahead of the reigning world champion Noah Lyles of the USA, who finished second at a season's best 9.85. Commonwealth champion Ferdinand Omanyala of Kenya finished third in 10.02. Seville says he was pleased with his execution.
Well, me and my coach was working on the execution throughout the week and the past month, and coming out here and get a good execution show that the work that they have put in paid off. Well, it's a tremendous feeling because, as I said, last year because of injuries, I didn't compete. But for this year, I'm actually happy that I compete and get a personal best and win in front of my Jamaican fans.
Yeah, meanwhile, Lyles, who had promised to take on Johan Blake's stadium record of 9.75 seconds, expressed disappointment with how quickly the gun went after the athletes were placed on set.
I was satisfied with the performance. I was disappointed in the gunman. I mean, none of us were even set. Half of us weren't even set before the gun went off. And that's very disappointing to see, but overall, the race was great. I came out here, I ran exactly what I thought I was gonna run, anywhere faster than 9.88. And, just today, it just wasn't what the wind was.
Yeah, Noah Lyles, he says he was disappointed with the gunman. I think what he really means is that he was disappointed with the starter. Not the term you want to be using when you're in Jamaica.
Jamaica, for sure. I learned that.
But definitely what he means is that he was disappointed with the starter. I felt while I was there that the gun, and not just for the men's 100 meters, that the athletes were being sent off relatively quickly after set. Okay. But I felt that way for the sprint hurdles. I felt that way for the women's 100 as well. And I think it is something that has developed in Jamaica over time, because in recent years, we've had a number of false starts at the National Stadium in Kingston at various levels, at the champs level and at the national and international levels as well. And so I think, especially when it comes on to big races, there's that fear that you will have false starts. And I think because of that fear, maybe sometimes the starters are a little bit quick with the gun. Now, I will say, to me, it is clear that, yes, it probably did affect Noah Lyles. When you look at the reaction times, for example, Noah Lyles had by far the slowest reaction time of anyone in the field. But outside of that as well, it was a reaction time that was by far slower than what even for him is normal. So he was at 0.189.
Yeah.
I look at his races in 2023, for example, and most of his races, his reaction time somewhere between 0.140 and 0.163, which incidentally was the reaction time of Oblique Seville. It was 0.163. So in fairness to Noah Lyles, I can understand that, especially someone who doesn't race in Jamaica as regularly as some of the others, might have been caught a little bit off guard by how quickly the gun went. But having said that, Lance and Mariah, Oblique Seville was simply sensational. His reaction wasn't superb either, but his start was magnificent. And I will dare say that even if Noah Lyles had reacted quicker to the gun, it would not have made a difference to the final result, because I think Oblique Seville would still have won the race.
Mm. Yeah, and you know, the fact is that the result of that race wasn't entirely surprising. To the global track and field fan, it may have been a shocker, but there were stories coming through the grapevine, Ricardo and Mariah, based on Seville's training and the work that he's been putting in for the past few weeks, that he was coming to do something special. So insiders weren't really surprised by what we saw on Saturday night.
No. Yeah,
I fully expected it. I thought he was in the shape to run 9.7, and I think that showed because he slowed with 5 or 6 meters to go looking across to Noah Lyles. But when I saw Seville for the first time this season in February, I think it was the Camperdown Classic, and he ran a personal best at 400, 47.44, and I thought to myself, he looked so strong. And for Oblique Seville, if you remember how Oblique Seville looked a year or two ago, very small, no real bulk, no real muscle. You look at him this season, he is starting to look like a sprinter. He's starting to look as if he's putting in some serious work in the gym. And he's also been able clearly to put in some work on the track as well. What a lot of people forget, Lance and Mariah, is that he had injury issues going into the Tokyo Olympic Games. He also had injury issues going into the World Championships last year in Budapest because he got hurt, I think, somewhere around the 21st or the 22nd of May, which was just over a week or two ahead of the Racers Grand Prix. Never made it back for the Racers Grand Prix, barely made it back for the Jamaica National Championships, where he got on the team and then ran brilliantly in the early rounds of the World Championships. But I think it was also evident that the type of work you need was not there for him to sustain that high level for the duration of three rounds. But I think that could be different this year.
Yeah, we want to go quickly to Julian Alfred and Jaden Hibbert. But just quickly, I heard him say something post-race, which to me is instructive as well. Yeah. His 400 and 200 efforts so far this season shows that he's putting some over-distance work, because he made the point that the three men who beat him in Budapest last year when he was fourth were 200-meter runners or did a bulk of 200-meter running. So he figures that with that kind of background early season, it would put him in a better position to be stronger over the 100 meters.
And it's working.
Yeah, and that's when I knew he was going to be better this year, Lance.
Yes,
when I saw him running 200s, because a couple of things. I don't think Coach Glenn Mills, who is a master at producing male sprinters, would be putting Oblique Seville in a position to run 200s if he didn't think his body was ready for it. And if his body is ready for the 200, meaning he is stronger, he has natural speed. This kid is a supreme talent. The natural speed is there. What he has lacked is the strength and the endurance and for his body to be able to handle that speed. And if that is there this season and he can go injury-free up to the Olympic Games, he is going to be very, very difficult to beat.
Julian Alfred was just as impressive as Seville was in many ways in the dominant win that she delivered on Saturday night.
Yeah, and of course, it was a national record for her of returning to Jamaica, because she went to high school in Jamaica the latter half of her high school years. And yeah, 10.78, national record, and also equaling the meet record set by Sharika Jackson last year. Here's Alfred following her sparkling run.
I was here and just work on execution. Didn't expect the time, that's why I was smiling so much. But I really just wanted to come out here, enjoy the crowd, work on execution in preparation for the Olympics.
She surprised herself, Lance, and she surprised me.
Did she?
Yeah.
You didn't expect this?
You mean the time?
Not 10.78.
Yeah.
I expected her to win. I saw the 10.93 that she produced at the Prefontaine Classic when she lost to Shakira Richardson, who is the reigning world champion. But 10.78 is not what I was expecting on Saturday night. It was a brilliant performance, and her transition, the start itself, that first 20.25, I don't think was stunning. Yeah. In fact, on the inside, Crystal Slowly and Tina Clayton, the two Jamaicans, probably got better starts than she did. But the transition from 30 to 60, that acceleration midway the race was terrific. I don't think I've ever seen it as good as that.
Yeah.
From Julian Alfred. And I'm starting to think, Lance and Mariah, that this is not just a girl who can run fast.
Yeah.
This is a girl who I think is ready for the big time. She is ready to be a serious challenger at the Olympic Games in Paris later this year.
I agree with you 100%.
Yeah, she looks really good. We had other winners on the day, Jaden Hibbert as well. And I want to talk about my Jareem Richards. from Trinidad and Tobago.
Well, let's hear from Jaden Hibbert first after that world lead, 17.75 meters to win the triple jump. And I tell you what, he had the crowd going. He was especially pleased about the performance, though, because his coach was not here in Jamaica. He's preparing for the NCAA championships. Let's hear from Jaden.
Every day when I go to training, it's sunshine. It's time to lock in because, especially, I'm a pro and I'm not a collegiate athlete, so my coach is not here at the meet. So I have to maintain focus. I have to constantly be listening in training, constantly be figuring it out. And I'm really proud of myself today because coach wasn't here. I did a technical event by myself. I didn't have anything but a video to watch. I didn't have his expertise to rely on, so I might just turn a jumps coach right now. Yeah, he knows me well. He knows my approach. He doesn't have to use anything. He knows it like that. And without him being here, it was kind of hard. I had to figure it out. That's why I did so much rounds. But I knew if he was here, I knew that I would have gotten it on my first round.
He's a showman, yeah. Ricardo. I love it.
Yeah,
he very much is. He very much is, in my opinion, a genuine superstar.
Love it.
The way he got the crowd going at the National Stadium in Kingston on Saturday was fabulous. Not that the crowd wasn't energetic before he took the stage, but when he did, it went up another level.
Yeah.
I have never seen a field event athlete get the crowd going like the way he did on Saturday. The closest to it I can think was when Shante Lowe Howard came to the Jamaica Invitational about 2010 or 2011 in the high jump, and
yes,
she had the crowd just mesmerized for a few minutes. But with Jaden Hibbert, it was just sustained all the way through his competition. It was magnificent.
Yeah, and he's looking like an Olympic gold medal favorite, Ricardo. I have to say that. And his 14-step approach Saturday was the first for the season. He's been doing 8 steps up till this point. And he just looks as if there's so much more that he can deliver. Yeah.
And interestingly, that 14-step approach, if memory serves me right, only happened on the fourth and final jump, the 17.75,
yeah,
because up to that point, I think he was utilizing the 8-step approach. I think definitely for the first 2 jumps, he went on the 8-step approach. So when you consider that even on 8 steps, he is able to go beyond 17 meters. And by the way, those efforts were all into a negative wind. So when you take that into consideration as well, the performance was just phenomenal.
So you agree that he's a gold medal favorite already?
I think so. He has to be at this stage. I think he was the favorite in Budapest last year. Unfortunately, he got hurt. Again, for Jaden, like Oblique Seville, it's all about staying healthy.
Correct. For all the athletes.
And those two are injury-prone, which is why it's even more important. But yeah, Mariah, Jareem, he came to Kingston finally and he got a win.
I know, and he's been competing in the 200 and the 400, and very soon he'll decide which one he takes part in.
Yeah, I found that interesting that he said he wasn't quite sure yet
which event he'll take on. Go Trinis!
Let's see.
Yeah.
Probably should go 4.